Hello, welcome to HCAT. Today we are going to show you Aqua Spray Booth, which is 24 inches. This machine is designed and working on basically three elements. One is water, air and light. As you can see, there is a heavy waterfall on the back side. Then there's a high suction of air. So the moment you spray on one side of the sheet, you can press the rotate button, and you can see the moment I press the rotate button, the sheet will come on second side and will stop here. So this heavy waterfall will take over all the big particles of your spraying, and this heavy suction of air filter will take all the fine particles of your ink.
Okay, after we finish up the spray process, we'll put this sheet inside the oven for baking. Now once the baking is finished, we will open the oven. We have been hanging these plates inside the oven. Now we will leave it outside in a room temperature for air dry. So it will take around 2 to 3 minutes. As you can see, the coating has been done on both the sides of the sheet. Here we are using 600 mm oven, which is 24 inches oven. So you can accommodate as much as 10 pieces at the same time. If you want to accommodate more pieces, you can buy a bigger oven, around 40 inches. Now we move on to the second step, which is an exposure. So this is a patented technology by HCAT. It's a specialized exposure machine which is based on iodine. Now the advantage of this exposure is that it's working on a 12 volt of electricity, and it doesn't consume 2 kilowatt like those old technology UV lamps. Now if you see, this is a positive. As you can see, it is on both the sides. So you can see the design. This is the design of a mesh on one side, and then this is the design of a mesh on the other side. Okay, so as you can see, there are some LED lights inside the exposure. So this will help your person to work in a dark area. As you know, this exposure has to be done in an almost like a shady area. So this will help you keep your sheet in the center of a design. Okay. Now we will place it inside the exposure. Lock the frames. Now this is a control panel. As you can see, this is a programmed control panel. Here you can see the vacuum. If you don't press the vacuum, the light will not work. So this is a programming which has been done in order to save your time, because sometimes after training, generally your workers will try to expose the design without pressing the vacuum to save the one step. So we made this as a programming in an exposure. If your worker is not pressing the vacuum, this machine would not work. Okay, now here you can see flash 1 and 1 plus 2, which is like one is for one side exposure, but since it is a double side exposure, we will press 1 plus 2. This also allows you to adjust the timing, but for this design, 2 minutes is okay. We'll just put once and to remove all the air. As you can see, now there is no air. It's very tight. Okay. Now we will close the exposure. Press 1 plus 2. So you can see two LEDs are blinking. So we'll wait for 2 minutes and then we will turn down. Okay, now as you see, it's about to finish. Now you can hear a beep sound. The machine will automatically go to a standby mode. The red light will switch on automatically. And since your machine on standby mode, so the vacuum is not working. So this will help you save your electricity on this. So even if your worker is somewhere else, the machine will automatically understand the job is over and it will go on a standby mode. Okay, now we are taking out the sheet, but at this stage you will not see anything on the sheet right now. As you can see, it's still plain. So we need to develop it. Now the next process is to put it inside a developing machine to develop it. So we'll expose about 2-3 plates more so that we can show you the developing process in production. Alright, after exposure we are moving towards the second step. Here you can see we have a small setup of etching line. So we have first machine, which is a developing machine. This has a sodium carbonate inside. So we are showing you now a production of mesh filter. So here you can see the temperature is already set at 31. This has a PID system. You just need to press the spray. The spray is on. Now it has a delta drive. You can set the speed as per your requirement. And then press run. Okay. Here you can see are moving inside. So this is a conveyor system. After the two sheets are completed, you can put another two sheets from the back side. So we'll show you, we have one more sheet ready. So we'll show you another sheet now. So this will keep on moving. Now this has, this machine is a 650 mm machine. This is a production area of almost like 900 square inches. So this process is a one-time process. From one side to the other, it will take approximately 1.5 minutes. So from the other side, we will have everything ready. Here you can see, this is an extension tray, so that any kind of chemical or water which is coming along with the material will go backside. We go back to the machine. So we just wait. It has all kind of caution stickers on it as per European norms. It has a OEM pressure gauge. If you can see that, it has etched written on it. So this will keep telling you the viscosity of the sodium carbonate. You can see, give you a close up. So there is no scrubbing. We have the sheets exposed, developed, ready. If you have a high production line, then you need another machine which will clean these sheets with water. Over here we will show you with normal water clearing. As you can see, there's some sodium water. You can see it's going back to the machine. Okay. Yeah, this is double side. Now this is double side. Complete three sheets ready. So this finish out the last the developing process. Now you have to clean the plate with the normal water. So this is the advantage of buying in conveyor machine. You have everything in production. Now we'll clean it with water and we'll start the etching process. coming to the next step, which is etching process. Here for etching we are using a 1 meter machine. You can see it's a 1 meter 1000 mm machine. It has a production capacity of almost like 1300 square inches. Now we'll switch on the conveyor and press the spray button. Now this machine has a connected blower, so it will take out all the fumes. Again, it's a conveyor machine, so after these three pieces are gone inside, you can put another three. Again, this machine is also equipped with a OEM pressure gauge, as you can see edge cut on it. It's OEM made specifically for our machine. You can see the high pressure. I'll introduce you to a pump. This pressure is coming because of this pump. We are the world's first company who are making the pumps in-house. As you can see here, it is equipped with Siemens motor. Okay, now this process from one side to the other side is almost like again 2 minutes as per the speed that we have put on our VFD system. But this process cannot be completed in a one go. So if you want to produce this mesh in production, you must have a bigger etching line. Since this is just a demo center, it's just a training center, so once we have these sheets out, we have to put these sheets back inside the machine from the front. So in one go we will just be able to etch it. In order to cut this sheet, which is about almost like 0.15 mm, we need almost like 15 to 20 minutes. This totally depends on a lot of factors. It depends on the quality of stainless steel. It depends on the grade of steel, the thickness of the sheet, and the quality of the chemical. Here you can see, again, this also is equipped with a safety extension tray. You will see some chemical coming along with the sheet. Now slowly it will accumulate, and from this hole it will go back to the machine. So you can see it's just a little bit of etching. Probably it might not be visible. We'll try. So we have to put it back this. We have to put it back inside the machine. Alright, in the meanwhile, let me show you around some other applications. So this is our conference room plus application center. These are the different applications. Okay, let's start with signages. You can see this is the indoor sign which has LED inside. If you see on top of it, this has been cut with the edge cut machine, then it has been manually welded to make it a channel letter. Now there's another application where CNC has been used to create a wooden letter, and inside wooden we have inlay the brass letter inside. Just below there is a nameplate which is showing you etching, cutting as well as bending. You can see that this bending is also possible with the machine. Okay, let's take a look at some other applications. This is stainless steel utensils. These are bangles. Alright, it's a wearing card box. This top has been cut in brass, it's gold plated. You can see it's a wedding card inside. Okay, this text is written in Arabic or Urdu. Okay, this is another fine example of stainless steel utensil. This is a high premium work. It's all done by machine. Okay, now let's take a look around on the wall. You can do photo etching, you can do corporate gifting, you can do signages, nameplates. Then of course you can create 3D models. It's a 3D model, this is a sheet inside. This is the wedding cards. You can do business cards. You can see this is a metal business card. It has a hanging jewelry. Let me show you. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Again, this is an application of those people who are using water jet. So with water jet, you can only cut metal. But if you have this machine along with your water jet, then there are other applications. If you see these letters, they're the etch cut letters. It has very fine work of etching. See that? And it's a single painting actually. It's a single artwork. Okay, these are the bookmarks. Again, wedding cards. It's trophies. Again, stainless steel utensils. These are the interior jali work. Nameplates. This is a color filling in signs. These are the etching on complete sheets. I'm sure you guys have seen those decorative stainless steel sheets. This is a similar kind of a work. Okay, here you can see a lot of other products. Some bookmarks, car hangings, mobile cover, then lockets, then these are the Christmas ornaments, then the earrings. So these are applications of etch cut. Alright, it took almost like 10 to 15 minutes and you can see that almost everything is ready. These are the three sheets. Almost all pieces are ready. Now the last process is to remove the coating ink of this the photoresist on this mesh. Now we have two methods to do that. Either we have another machine which is spraying plastic soda, or else we have another option of stripping tank. In this tank we have an option of where we can take this a tank into tank system. Basically it works on a signs of volume and water. So the idea behind making this machine is that probably your staff has a problem or your worker has a problem cleaning by caustic soda by hand. So we made this unique concept in which the caustic soda is inside. It has a PID system, titanium temperature controller, titanium heater. So you just need to put all these sheets inside and it will remove all the ink. Or if you have a high production, then you can go for another machine. Here in the demo center, we have displayed our 370 mm machine. Now the idea behind putting these three machines here, the first one is 650 mm machine. This is a developing machine. And then there is a 1 meter etching cutting machine, and the third is 370 mm stripping machine. So the idea is we want to show you how machines are convertible. The convertible means these are the same machines. You can see the same electrical, same pump, everything same, but we can use these machines for three purpose. So maybe if you don't have a budget today and you are buying just the etching cutting machine, in future if you buy for a bigger machine, you can convert this machine. You can use this machine for cleaning purpose, developing purpose. So in the meanwhile, we have many options for you. So we'll show you just one sample. Now we need to clean it with water. Okay, this is a scrap. The scrap comes along with every sheet. Okay, we clean one of the pieces with water. You see all this accumulated ferric chloride. It will not go on the floor, it will go back to the machine. Can we see one piece? Okay. Now we'll try to show you. Okay. Let us see how far. Okay, maybe with the light it will be easy for you. Okay. Now you can see. Okay, let us see if we can. This is the perfect holes all over. Now here we are using 0.15 sheet.
So it's perfectly clear. It has some water.
Now we will put all these sheets inside this stripping tank. Now it is not necessarily that you will be doing one by one piece. This is just a demonstration. We can probably put all these pieces together in a sheet. So in that case we have to make a design in such a way so that this piece will be adjoining with the material. So there will be a small line which is known as bridge. So we'll create a bridge so all these pieces will stay together. So that totally depends on how you want to work. So this is just a demonstration on how you can achieve. So probably here you can see, and this machine has a capacity of 1300 square inches. So probably in 10 minutes we can easily do almost like 200 pieces. So now this is the last step. We'll just put it inside. We'll leave everything for about 10 to 15 minutes. If you have a production, then of course you can go for a machine as discussed before. Okay, we'll join you in 10 minutes. We'll show you the final piece once this ink has been removed. Thank you. Let me show you around our company, our office, and the sample. Okay, this is my office. Okay, these are the countries we are working with: Dubai, Tokyo, Japan, of course, India. This is Mexico, South America, and New York, US. Okay. Okay, these are the samples. These are the ready samples. Juicer. This is how we manufacture machines. So this is how it starts. It starts from a welding. There's the different machines. You can see some round etching machine. This one is a 360 degree machine. It's still all under production. This is a spray booth, then 1 meter machine. This is all under testing. These are customized department. This is a packaging department. So this is our production flow. These are some of the achievements of our company, Edgecut. These are some of the good design books that we refer. Alright, finally, we are here back again. As you can see now, all caustic has been moved back to the tank. And these are all the sheets already. Let us check. Just need to be cleaned with water now. Right, we have the sheets clean now. You can see. So there is no change in the material property. You see the metal remains same. And if you want to give a branding of any company, you can give a branding as well, though it is not provided in the sheet. So finally everything is ready for dispatch.